Hello, welcome to the Checkpoint with me, Vivian Kamsimi. The Forum for Democratic Change is a major opposition political party here in Uganda. But this week, two factions emerged, with each accusing the other of being a mole. Now, defections in the FDC started with Betty Kamya, who defected then to form the Uganda Federal Alliance. And then Major General Mugisha Muntu also defected in 2017 to form the Alliance for National Transformation. And now it appears that there could be a likelihood of another split in the FDC. The other parties, like the UPC Democratic Party, have also had factions within their parties and are working in close cooperation with the NRM. What is failing political parties in Uganda, and what can be done to strengthen these parties? To discuss with me on set is the Honorable Dr. Miriam Matembe, former Minister of Ethics, and Mr. Timothy Chemonges, a policy analyst. Ladies and gentlemen, you're welcome.
Thank you.
To start
and
with,
good evening, viewers.
Yes. To start with, I will begin with you, Dr. Matembe. It was once reported that you wanted to join the FDC. What happened then?
Who was reporting? Is it you, the press, or what? Because if they reported that I wanted to join FDC, I think they didn't even know the origin of the FDC and how it started. Because when you look at FDC and how it started with the YPA joining, what was the other one? The is it the reform agenda and YPA formed, they were the foundation of FDC. And when you look at that, you call me a founding member of FDC. So if they start saying, I once wanted to join, I think they didn't know what they were doing. What I know is that when we founded FDC, you count me as a founding member. We joined. But the difference is that I never, after the party was registered, I never registered myself as a member of FDC. But as for the formation on that hill where we were, when we formed it, I was, you can call me a founding member. That is one. Two, even when you look at this, is it
ANT, Alliance for National Transformation.
That one, right from the beginning, when he traveled around, when he was forming, we were all together. You may not know the people who were with Muntu as he worked out this, the ANT. But I am one of those who worked out that. But upon registration, I also did not register as a member.
Yes, I saw that information.
You wouldn't say that I'm a member, but founding.
You are a founding mother to these two.
Yeah, maybe you call that.
If I should say. But then you don't get to become their member. I saw that information where they actually met at your home. Just before they formed the Alliance for National Transformation.
ANT.
Yes.
Yeah, we used to
meet. Yes.
In our homes, not only mine, but in some homes which.
Yes. So I know that out. Information. Mm. I also know that at some point when you came out to stand as an independent member of parliament after you had not supported the Chisanja, you also did not want to be mentioned as a member of the FDC, like you just said, and yet you had been a founding person of this party. Why? Why didn't you want to be a part of this party, these parties actually? Not even one party, the FDC, but ANT as well. Why?
If you really want to know my mind, I want to say that the betrayal, the deep, deep betrayal I got from President Museveni when he turned things around from where we were going and where they went. To me, I had never been a member of any political party. I had joined UPM. I joined UPM because we young people embraced President Museveni, just like the young people were embracing NUP. I mean, this where is the name? Chagwanyi.
Yes. Eh?
We also
Bobby Wine.
Yes, we also embraced Museveni at our time there. And of course, I did not become an active, but I joined, like you say, this is the part I will go to. I couldn't go to UPC. I have documented these things, they are documented. I couldn't go to UPC. I couldn't go to DP. I had my reasons. I thought UPM was a new thing, which we thought we could begin a new thing rather than going in those old things which had not worked well. So when Obote reached the elections of 1980 and UPM reached nowhere, our founder ran into the bush. Me, I did not run to the bush. I stayed here, but my cousins, my uncles, my whatever, some of them died there, some of them came back and died later, some of them maybe are still alive but dumped somewhere there. So when President Museveni arrived here, he said, wow, what we had wanted is here. And I embraced, I should say, more than 100%. And when I went into the work that I did for this country, mine was beyond 100%. And down the road, the betrayal. You know, when you trust somebody and you are entirely betrayed and you can't believe it, because I remember even when he was calling me after removing the term limit, he called me, please come back. And I asked him, when I joined you, you were like here. Now you are here. Who are you? Whom should I join? And I said, secondly, when I joined you, you were a straight path, which we knew where we were going. But now you have jumped off the straight path and onto the bush. You've gone back into your bush, and me, I've never been to the bush. So how can I follow when I don't know where I'm going? So that betrayal, which I had, I want things to happen in the right manner, but I find it difficult to trust somebody, to run with somebody again, to be betrayed again. So my heart, I sort of protect my heart. But when they come and say, would like to do this, yes, I join, and we get ideas, we put them together and say, okay. And I cannot, one thing I'll tell you, if somebody like any of those people won, and they called me, come and help us in the work, and they give me work to do, that one, I would go to do that work to serve Uganda as a nation, and not basically because of the party or the leader that I'm following.
I'm sorry, Doctor, about your heartbreak, about between your expectations and what you actually got when this regime came into power. But just before I bring in Timothy, let me just go for a very short break, and then I'll be back.